This morning we're heading toward Moraine Lake. You can see the top of this mountain here in some clouds. But otherwise, it's a bright, pretty morning. Pretty impressive glaciers hanging up there, aren't they? You see a turnoff, I'll take it. This glacier hanging here is quite impressive. That was a steep little climb, huh?
Yes.
This is Moraine Lake. The view in the back of the Canadian $20 bill. It is impressive.
That's it. I mean, I just might hold on to some of the things. That's all you.
Not a wide enough angle to do this justice.
Sieht alles nicht die schneller als diese blöden Batterien. Ne?
Ja, also ich muss sagen, entweder sind die Batterien besser geworden, ich habe jetzt meine so lang. Das
ist ja größer, oder?
Das ist ja viel größer. Ja.
Das ist ja besonders groß. Das ist ja wahrscheinlich der Lithium mit.
Ja.
Wahrscheinlich jemand anders.
Ja.
Das ist ungefähr. Also doppelt so groß, zwei bis drei so groß wie die, das ist doch ungefähr. Die haben ja auch genauso einen Motor drin, der Filmriss drin.
Das kostet sehr viel Energie. Ja.
Also das ist ein Sitzmitleiter sogar und das kostet anscheinend relativ wenig Wasser.
Now apparently the third toe of the crowfoot would have hung down in back of this tree right here, in that crevice, right? That would have produced the crow's foot, the three toes. Kind of down there. Just sort of an edge with trees up at the top there, and the falls just come streaming over the edge. If you can see up on the edge here, the mountains go up thousands of feet still, straight up. Riderville Falls stop, but really, the view back to the valley here is the view of Riderville Falls is almost incidental. See the old strata in these mountains around here. Old strata. Strata.
see there's a parking lot up ahead there. And
trail of people.
Yes, the glacier itself, of course, is right there. The trail of people, the parking lot's there. And the people are there, and there's buses up in the ice. They have their own road up there.
I'm seeing it right now. It's farther up there.
Well, I might slip my sweater on for this one.
Now, how far on that ice are we going to walk? My tennis shoes are not good. No traction.
Change of shoes, huh?
So, we're at the Athabasca Glacier.
Uh-huh.
We're on the edge here, the toe of the glacier.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know, it's 100 yards wide or so or more. You can see all the moraine material off the sides. There's rock above here, and then moraine material along here. Here's the toe of the glacier through here, and there's a few people. Oh, my hat was zooming in. And then down below here, apparently just down where the cars are, that glacier was that far down, 56. This is, of course, several hundred yards farther along. You can see some of the blue of the glacial ice and some of these crevices up in here.
Here you can see the trail back down from the glacier. And the glacier used to go down almost, but in the mid-50s, almost to the parking lot down there. So, and this is of course all the moraine till type material that's been deposited in these areas. Some rock outcroppings here and there, but you can see the till piled up along the sides. It's quite deep. And then there's the glacial melt and a little pond down below, a little lakelet. And there's a glacial gnome.
Can I have the camera?
Sure.
What?
And these are Jim's toes. He wore sandals up on top of this glacier and then dipped his toes into the glacial flour and then had to rinse them in the glacial melt, which was probably about 32 degrees. And now his toes are cold. And I think he's ready to go back to the car. Okay.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Saskatchewan?
Saskatchewan? Well, I suppose it could be off to the back of this peak that's over here. And then out in front of us here is the Athabasca. Now, the Athabascan has been retreating the last, at least since last century or so. It's of course, the edge is right here now. And somewhere around where the parking lot is here, in the 1950s it was down to that edge. So it had been over this little hump here and falling over that. And then, going farther back to around, turn of the century, it's right up to just the other side of this road here. So it's really receded quite a ways. But one thing that you don't realize is that lengthwise along the glacier, you're looking up it, there's a fairly flat slope, and looking a long distance along back up toward that falls back there in the Columbia Ice Field. What you see out there in the ice field are snow coaches, and they're taking people out there on their little road that they've carved, $22 a shot for a 1 hour tour. And when you get out there, you can kind of walk around and see this ice ball that's out there. Now you can see some people down below there. They've actually walked up from below. Now, they warn people pretty strongly that these crevices that you see in the ice there are sometimes fairly hidden by the snow. This time of year might be better because it might be opened up
worse.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway.
It could be a complete snow bridge at 10 in the morning and a complete collapse at 2 in the afternoon.
Well, anyway, people fall in those and get trapped 10 meters down and die. Typically right near the frontier even. There's a little trail that goes up. Again, a parking lot, 1950s, glacier is down here. And then up toward where it is now is, of course, 1997. And then there's more glaciers off to the right here. I don't recall the name of this one. That was the Dome Glacier. And this is the Columbia Ice Field Center that we're at, standing looking out from. So Dome Glacier, Athabascan Glacier, and its drainage field, little lake at its base. And the Saskatchewan Glacier. Back of all those, for a few tens of kilometers, is a huge ice field called the Columbia Ice Field. Its myriad of people.
days.
You can actually see the blue in the ice here, can't you?
Here we are. At the end of the road and the top of the mountain.
And
at supper time.
Oh, there's some nice red mountains behind us.
Yeah.
Well, what's the name of the place here?
This is Mount Edith Cavell.
You mean that big one behind us?
Yep.
You mean right up there in the clouds? It's got clouds stuck to the top.
Yep, and the glacier that's hanging in there is called Angel Glacier.
Yeah, and it's just a little flat spot between peaks there, sort of, and it's just kind of heaped in there, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
And one leg of it's flowing out here, huh? It's kind of like a ice fall. And there's rapids in it. And down at the bottom, it's calving. There's big chunks there that are laying on the ground. And water coming out from underneath it. Here we are, 100 or 200 yards along the trail, a little closer to the glacier here. And the rapids coming down, spilling out of the mouth, and finally falling apart and turning to water. Now farther and down, there's quite a sort of cliff here where it kind of makes a break between the ice above, and there's sort of a piece down at the foot of the cliff here, and it looks like it might be just moraine material, kind of gray and pebbly, except when you look down here, there's a body of water down here, and it looks like an ice face that probably calves on occasion there. And falls into that water body. We'll go see if we can see that a little better down below.
It's all downhill.
Yes, all downhill.
Let's go.
There are some past pictures of this. Here we are in 1915. Again, today there's a gap between the angel above and the ice and snow below. And then in 1922, somewhat different vantage point, but you can see that it, probably from the hill of Mackabas, still it's a complete fall down that cliff. And even as recent as 1978 here, you can see it's almost completely covering that face. And now is a gap. And here, finally, we can pull away from the Angel and see that ice clump down below. You can see
Cavell Glacier right here.
That is which?
Cavell Glacier.
Cavell Glacier,
mm-hmm,
I see.
Glacier.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Now, Mount Edith Cavell, 3,363 meters tall, and back here. And this is Cavell Glacier, and what does it say about it?
Nothing.
The snow avalanches down from this mountain because it's so sheer and piles up in these areas to form these glaciers. And it's on the northeast face. Once again, for a map of this, here's Angel Glacier and the snow avalanche cones at the base and Cavell Glacier. So Cavell Glacier there. Had a bunch of people down there around that lake, waiting no doubt for calving to occur. Rapids of Angel Glacier. Look at some of these faces once again. Well, we'll take a parting shot here because the mountaintop is cleared out. No longer in the cloud up there. And you can see a cornice of snow. Who knows, maybe some of that snow on the cornice occurred today, huh? Easy to see how you can get an avalanche off the top there. Whoosh, down the mountain. Here's some people getting within way too close. Waiting for the elk to cross the road here. They kind of just amble through. Both. Oops. Here they are again. They're just minding their own business. We're not. Here's one trying to cross the road. Doing just fine. They kick their legs out when they walk. Hind legs. And then another one coming across. They're about all wet. Less than the car's distance away here. Well, I suppose we should go by. People watching the people. I can hear. Yeah, help to reach you. This is the Athabasca River. Already, this is a big river here. It's been flowing for a while, much like the Columbia does along the mountains. Makes a big turn and then flows back in another direction. The Athabasca ends up in the Arctic Circle.
Arctic Ocean.
Arctic Ocean, for that matter. And along the way, of course, traverses a lot of country, goes through some great big lakes. No doubt, yeah, there's a whole lot more water before it dumps up there. Right here, the color is glacial, greenish kind of color. It's greenish gray.
Not the emerald green, though.
Right.
The gray green.
From the so-called glacial flower that's in it. I had to take a little more footage of the river here because the sunlight has finally come out and blessed us this afternoon. And we've definitely changed the look